right on now. Very funny gentleman. Please give it up to Mr. Doug Ray.
The bus was a little late getting in from the home, but I'm here. Men are pigs. Men are pigs. They are pigs, right? I walked in my house last week, walk in the door, my wife says, "Men are pigs." And I was like, the senator's going to run for another session. It's like, what is that phrase? When pigs will fly, right? And he's going to run for senator when pigs will fly. That's not going to happen. I mean, the pigs are all coming out of the sty now. They're not flying anywhere. But the thing you have to remember, what's the difference between men and pigs? you know what it is, huh? Pigs don't turn into men when they drink. Right. Unfortunately. Oh, by the way, I got some little business. Excuse me, sir. Are you the person that lost that roll of $100 bills?
Yes.
In the rubber band?
Yeah.
Oh, great. I found the rubber band. That'll work. When I find the money, I won't let you know. Anyway, everybody's been so nice here and welcoming. And Tom said, wished me well. He said, just don't die out there. I don't know if I hope he's talking about the jokes. I'm not quite sure. My wife said, when I left the house, she said, break a leg. Tom said, break a hip. These are period pieces. But you know, I don't know why I'm up here. I want to prove that I can get up here, older people still have fun. You know, and surprises happen every day. Like last summer, I was doing my yard work, and across the street I could see this gorgeous young widow. I could see she's walking toward me, and she comes up to me, looks me in the eye, and she says, "I know your wife is out of town, and I'm a little bit horny, and I want to go drinking, and I want some wild sex. Are you busy tonight?" No. She said, "Great, can you watch my dog for me?" That's my life in a nutshell right there. The dog and I had a good time. We watched Cujo. Kind of breaking that dog in to deal with her later. See how that works out. You know, it's lucky I didn't get together with the widow. There's a good chance that I might have been charged with assault with a dead weapon. And that's a sad story, but in fact, on eBay, I got scammed on eBay because I paid $150 for a penis enlarger, and they sent me a magnifying glass. That's not funny. That's not good at all. You know what you get? When you get older, you start thinking about death. And everybody here is so young, they don't have to control it, worry about that. But I was thinking about death, and I pulled my family around, and I said, "Listen, I don't want to be left in a vegetative state where they got me plugged into a machine, and they got drips of something coming into my system to keep me alive. What I want you to do is pull the plug, okay?" So they went out, they pulled the plug on my computer, and they threw all my wine away. Sad situation. But you know, I can't get a word in edgeways with my kids, and so what happens is, I'm going to have the final word with these guys. I gather them, I'm in my bed, and I have the family around me, and I'm going in my last breath, I say, "I hit $1 million They'll never find it. I know, that's good stuff. You know, people wonder what you do with your time. I got a little bit of background in chemical engineering, and what I do is I convert beer, wine, and liquor into urine. It's an ongoing process. It takes a lot of time. I used to work at a helium factory, but I quit because I don't like being spoken to in that tone of voice. Not good. That's those students, right? Okay, let me think. Yeah, I don't like being in that tone of voice. As an aside, donkeys cause more deaths annually than airplane crashes. So make sure you watch your ass. I like that one. Anyway, to leave you with, this is a short program, but to leave you with a life lesson. Life is transmitted sexually. So if your parents didn't have children, there's chances you won't either. I'm sorry. Before I came out, I got a call from the widow. She wants me to come over and got to work with the dog again tonight. That's my show. Thanks.
Right.